I don't think there's anyone in history I wouldn't give the edge to Tom Brady with. Literally anyone. I think he could face... I would put Tom Brady against the best players of all time. I still think he'd have a decent day. The dude is once-in-a-lifetime talent, and so...
Is going to need a thing after retiring. He didn't do a lot of commercials.
No.
He didn't do a lot of advertisements. That was Peyton Manning's thing.
Yep.
Peyton Manning did the advertisements. He was the funny man. Tom Brady was the workhorse. And Tom didn't really do this until recently when, again, he knows his career is on the way out.
He has enough money, and Giselle has even more money. I don't think he needs to worry about that. But, I mean...
No, but I mean, in Cleveland, we had Brian Hoyer, right? The hometown kid. But he was Brady's understudy. And Hoyer was talking about they were on the practice field the one day, and Brady comes over to him and says, "Hey, Rook, what are you going to do in this situation?" And he rattled off, like, you know, the defense is giving you a cover too deep, and this is the play call. What do you do? And Brian Hoyer looked at him and said, "I don't know, man. I'm the third-string quarterback." He says, "Well, you got to know." And so, like, Brady, like, led him by the hand, made him go back and walk through it again, and, like, basically taught Brian Hoyer, like, look, I don't care if you're the third string. You got to prepare like you got my job if you want a job in this league.
I mean, look at Matt Castle. That's what gave him a job. Like, Brady was working with Matt Castle that 2006 year. Matt Castle is not a 10-6 quarterback.
No.
But that team went 10-6.
Yeah, and I think that's what's going to happen with Jimmy Garoppolo.
Yeah, please, dear God, keep Garoppolo out of Cleveland.
Jacoby Brissett. That team won this year with Jacoby Brissett as quarterback.
Yeah, everybody's saying who? And Belichick's sitting there, exactly.
Now, and I don't think, look, and just proof of all the quarterbacks that have gone through the Patriots to other things, I don't think it's a system thing with Tom Brady. I really don't. And that's everyone's knock on Tom Brady. Well, in that case, you could say Joe Montana was a system quarterback. You could say Steve Young was a system quarterback. You could say Troy Aikman was a system quarterback because they didn't leave those teams. And so, like, I think just because a player has been on one team forever does not mean they're a system quarterback. I mean...
Well, I think after a while you start to tailor, like, they may come in and the system may work for them. But I think after a while, though, like, the system ends up tailoring to that quarterback. I mean, you look at Peyton Manning. When he moved from Indianapolis over to Denver, Denver changed their entire offensive scheme to fit Peyton Manning.
Yeah. I mean, they had Tebow there, for gosh sake, before.
And what did Tebow do? What did Tebow do? Gabe?
Tebow was...
Gabe, what did Tebow do?
He won, because that's what Tebow did.
He did. He beat who?
Hey, Tubby, do you want to talk about the last time the Browns made it to the playoffs?
Oh, my goodness, guys. You guys need to stop this.
You want to talk about the last playoff win for Cleveland? Because the Steelers were just 2 weeks ago, was it? Because I think it's been about 500 weeks for Cleveland.
Oh, my goodness, you guys. This is...
I'd rather make it to the playoffs and lose.
This is why we separate these two. This exactly right here. Oh, my goodness.
See, all this entertainment right here on The Morning After on 88.9 WFSE, Fighting Scots Radio. We're talking with Gabe Andrew. They're over at Macomb Fieldhouse for wheelchair basketball. I'm your host, Tubby, and I'm here at the studio all by myself. And apparently, thank God for that, because Gabe would stab me in the throat.
These guys are about to have a fist fight.
Can we break? Can we go to break?
No,
because we got like 10 minutes left in the show. Suck it up, Buttercup. Let's roll.
The game's starting in 5. I need to get my pre-show prep.
I'll say this. Going back to the what we were talking about before you two decided to be at each other's throats, it is Brady as a system quarterback. And yes, you can look at quarterbacks like Peyton Manning, who went to two different places and was great. You can look at Kurt Warner, who did the same thing, was actually the first quarterback to take two different teams to a Super Bowl.
Lost to who? The Pittsburgh Steelers.
Oh, my goodness. He also lost to Brady as a Ram. But you look at what good quarterbacks do. Yes, you have certain quarterbacks who have certain traits. and certain types of styles. Like, you have your dual threat quarterbacks, you have your pocket passers, you have a big bruiser quarterback like a Big Ben. But when you have a good coach and a good quarterback, who, yes, the offense will be tailored to the quarterback, but a quarterback still has to play. Tom Brady has had no one around him on that offense. And yet, year after year, they're a guarantee to be in the AFC Championship. Rob Gronkowski has been hurt for the last 2 years. Like, I've heard people say it's time to move on from Rob Gronkowski. So, you look at Tom Brady's receivers. Julian Edelman was a quarterback. Danny Amendola was, I believe he was a quarterback as well. Chris Hogan, who was a lacrosse player before playing 1 year of college football. Those are the guys he's throwing to, and he's making them incredible. Brady took a Wes Welker, who was absolute garbage in Miami. And Wes Welker is arguably, like, one of the best small receivers ever. Deion Branch did nothing after he left the Patriots. Randy Moss was a flameout in Oakland. He went to New England with Tom Brady as the quarterback, and he became the best. He had the best statistical year of a wide receiver.
I also think that has something to do.
Tom,
a quarterback can't succeed without a line. A line can't succeed without a quarterback. A running back can't. Like, it's give and take. It's a team sport. So
I've always said this, though. The quarterback makes the receiver.
I think you're absolutely right.
I don't think it's the other way around. I believe a quarterback makes the receiver. Look who's not doing anything right now. Demaryius Thomas. Have you heard from him in the last couple years?
And then, I mean, look at...
Peyton Manning made him who he was.
Look at Pittsburgh. I mean, I think Pittsburgh's a really good example of it, because somehow, it doesn't matter who's in, it seems like the wide receivers, Pittsburgh always has a great core of wide receivers. Do I think they're, like, some huge, huge talent? I mean, AB was drafted in the fifth or sixth round. Like, I think a big part of it is Ben. I really do think that. And then look at what Brady's doing right now with a Penn State lacrosse player, and he blew up against the Steelers. I mean, I think you're right, Drew. I think a lot of it, but I think that's with anything. A quarterback can't succeed without his teammates. A running back can't. Middle linebacker can't succeed. It's football. It's not like a sport like wrestling that we have tonight at 7 o'clock, me and Tubby on the call. We have where it's mono, it's one-on-one, it's That's what's fun about wrestling, but football, it's a team 11 guys effort.
Yeah, and I mean, my biggest proof here, my final thing on this, my biggest proof for the quarterback makes the receiver is actually Eli Manning. Look what he's done in the Super Bowl. David Tyree,
I think that
was a superstar in that Super Bowl. David Tyree had done nothing. He won the Super Bowl with a David Tyree as receiver. Look at the next time they face the Patriots, Mario Manningham, who really in the NFL has not done anything.
I haven't heard that name in quite a while. I'm surprised you remembered that name.
And so I think the quarterback makes the receiver. All right, Tubby.
Get off.
We're about ready to start here at this match. It's Edinburgh and the Canadian under-23 team.
Are they both wearing... Okay, I thought they were both wearing red, I was about to say.
They're both red and white, but Edinburgh's going to wear the white uniforms here. All right, we can take a quick 2-minute or quick 1-minute break. Give us a PSA, and we'll be back for the start of this one here. Thank you so much. We'll be back in just a moment.
All righty, this has been The Morning After right here on 88.9 WFSE Fighting Scotch Radio. Up directly next, right after this, is Wheelchair Basketball live from Macomb Fieldhouse with Gabe and Drew on the call. So until Monday, when we recap all of this, have a great day, Burrow.
Live Fighting Scotch Sports from the Edinburgh Sports Network on 88.9 WFSE, Edinburgh.
Crayons and clean water, the surprising connection on this current cast. In Pennsylvania, abandoned coal mines have left a dirty legacy. Thousands of miles of streams polluted by acid mine drainage. Wetlands can be used to treat the water, but in the process, they accumulate a lot of metal sludge that has to be removed, often at great expense.
And so I ended up exploring the idea that this pure sludge might have marketable value.
That's Bob Hedden of Iron Oxide Recovery. He found the rusty-colored material could be used to make pigment for paint and crayons.
If you get a burnt sienna crayon out of your Crayola mix, it is iron oxide for mine drainage.
By turning a liability into an asset, his company makes remediation projects more economically sustainable. Current Cast, produced with Cornell's Atkinson Center for a Sustainable Future and made possible by the Foundation for Pennsylvania Watersheds. Online at currentcast.org.
It's time for another live Fighting Scott Sportscast. This is 88.9 WFSE with the Edinburgh Sports Network.
Welcome back here. We have wheelchair basketball for you right here from Macomb Fieldhouse. I'm Drew Patrick. Alongside me is Mr. Gabe Hypes, bringing you the action of all of Edinburgh's games today at the Edinburgh Intercollegiate Tournament. Now the Fighting Scots, they're wearing white, and they're against the Canadian National Under-23 team. And Chase Wolf is starting for the Edinburgh Fighting Scots, and Chase actually was selected to the United States Under-23 team, so a bit of a scouting game for him. And Canada has it in the corner. Pass back out to the top. Down low, Atherley has a hand on it, knocks that one out of play. 18 seconds left to shoot, knocked back almost by midcourt. Around Canada. Pass down, it's Willie Moronic. Pass down, shot is up. This one off, no good. Missed shot. Garrett Ostepchik. And we have a stoppage as Wolf was flipped. Nothing here, first half. Vincent DeLassi has it for Canada. Driving down, trying to swing this over, but Kevin Atherley takes it away. He's on the charge. He'll pull back, pass this one to Wolf. Chase Wolf gliding in, but can't get the layup to go. He was wide open there, just bad positioning getting in there. Trying to go coast-to-coast layup, no good. And Wolf had to save it, and rebound goes to Kevin Atherley. The Fighting Scots across. Atherley going to coast himself. He's fouled.
A jam-packed day for wheelchair basketball. We have two games going on here right now on the backcourt and the front court. So, I mean, all around. And we have more games going on in Crawford. Is that right, Drew?
Well, I think they're going to be here, though, the whole time. We might have, I think they practice over at Crawford, though. So there is wheelchair basketball at Crawford. Pass down low. Atherley off the glass. No good. He gets his own rebound. Second chance will fall. And the Fighting Scots strike blood first. Canada trying to respond. Layup is good on a great pass down low. Mike Adams, the All-American for the Fighting Scots. Adams. Trying to move around. Shot is up. This one off. No good. Ball is loose. And will speed the first to get over, but one of the wheels goes out of bounds. So that's out of play. Pass in. Driving pass down low, and a good shot there Willie Ronchick. Mike Adams now trying to respond. It's 2-2. Adams will stop at the top. He get a shot if he wanted over to Wolf. They go back to Adams getting reset. Adams is their long ball shooter. He drives in. Shot is up. This one off. No good. We're still tied at 2. Canada trying to respond. Vincent DeLassie. Pass over to Willie Moronchik. Back to DeLassie. And they swing it over to the far side. Shot is up off the front. No good. Alex Slay able to come down with the rebound. Pass out to Adams. Adams going around into that far side corner. They'll swing it over to Chase Wolf. Wolf shot is up. This one falls. And Edinburgh takes the 4-2 lead.
Kind of a slow start to the game. A lot of missed opportunities for both sides. I think it's just the first game of the day for both teams, and so they started off kind of cold.
It's a little early, but that looked pretty good as Willie Moronchik just coasting in there. And good picks to give a hole in the middle, and he went 4-4. Speed. Over to Wolf. Driving in, down low to Atherly. Good pass, and it doesn't fall, but Atherly able to come away with the rebound. Slay driving in, kick out to Adams. Adams trying to get around, cutting through, almost lost the ball. Fights for it, shot is up, no good. Rebound by Canada. Pass ahead, wide open, Vincent DeLassie. Leaked out. Layup is no good as that one falls off. It was a good positioning, good layup. That was just that unfriendly roll around the rim. Atherly. Over to Adams. Adams on the far side in the corner. Pass back out to Atherly. Driving in. Shot is up. He hits the deck. They reset. Ooh. Pass ahead and a block there. That foul will be on Alex Slay.
Kind of a hard foul with, I believe that was Alex Hayward who kind of hit the ground, hit the dirt, face forward. So, but he got right back up and play will resume right now.
DeLassie. Pass down low. Good pass down low. Shot is up. But no shot. So he'll get 2 at the line. The score 6-4 in favor of the Canadian team. First shot is no good. Ayuba Ali comes in for the Fighting Scots. Second shot, no good as well. And Mike Adams comes away with it.
A lot of missed shots so far for both
sides. You just got to warm up.
Yeah.
Adams trying to drive in there, scooting around, but we have a foul.
That was the thing. The last time we were able to watch wheelchair basketball, it was like some games they scored 75, some games it was like 30. I mean, it's kind of unpredictable.
Yeah, you just got to find your shot. And we have another foul, I believe. Nope. I heard a whistle. It was just the other side.
I got confused a couple of times already also.
But shot missed for Adams. Pass ahead. They get it back to DeLassie on the cut. He stopped. Pass over. It's Tamek. Pass down low. Great pass, but shot no good. Ayuba Ali able to get the rebound. That was good positioning. There might be a lid on that basket, though.
I really think so. I mean, it seems like easy shots that are being missed right now. It's weird. They usually, especially this Edinburgh team that we've seen, don't miss those type of shots.
Speed of the shot. It's up. This one is off. No good. Off the front of the rim. It was a good shot, but Speed just couldn't get it down. Canada trying to extend their lead. They have that 2-point lead, 6-4. Pass back out to the top, down low. This one off the glass and in. And a timeout for Coach Glatch and the Edinburgh Fighting Scots as your score is now 8-4.
Still no. There we go. Finally update. I remember the last time we watched wheelchair basketball. I think it was the case of not keeping the right score a couple of those times. And there were some close games, and so I think a couple games got affected by the scoreboard operator not clocking the 2 points or 3 points, whatever they were supposed to. But, you know, that's, I guess, just the way it goes.
I think they also have backups, too. They have people each with a book to make sure the scoreboard operator...
Maybe I was just wrong.
Who knows?
I'm not usually wrong, though. Especially on the morning after.
Oh, my goodness. You guys are still having at it. Edinburgh Fighting Scots are coached by Coach Jim Glatch and assistant coach Joe Gironi and, of course, assistant coach Trayvon Jennifer, who's got a gold medal to his name. Ali with it for the Fighting Scots. Drive his way forward. He stops in his tracks, trying to give it to Wolf. He does. Over to Will Speed. Pass to Adams. Adams trying to set up his shot. Has a shot. This one up and good for Mike Adams.
And it's opened up the floodgates.
That's what you want to see from your All-American. Driving in, trying to scoot around. Layup is good. Off balance for Willie Brachuk.
Kind of a good move to get down low, and then even better move to get out, because if you're not familiar with wheelchair basketball, you can kind of block your opponent down there at the lineup and make a shot.
Ayuba Ali spinning and hitting the deck hard.
And he fell hard right on his head. He is still down. The ref is making sure he's okay.
Now, in Ayuba Ali was hurt for the Fighting Scots, and they're going to bring out the trainer to take a look. So we're going to take a 30-second break. We're going to stay here?
We're going to stay here.
We're going to stay here. They're looking at Ayuba, who hit the deck hard on his back or his head. Your source for Fighting Scots coverage is the Edinburgh Sports Network, including 88.9 WFSC and EdinburghNow.com. With ETV, the campus television station, also featuring many of the home contests. This game broadcast is provided in part by Bonnell's Auto Group, featuring collision services in Erie and Fairview, auto glass replacement and repair in Fairview, auto sales in Erie and Fairview, and full rod shop services and restoration in Fairview. Information on each service is on the web at bonnellsauto.com. Now, you can also see the games that we're doing. Here we are streaming live on the Edinburgh Now YouTube page. And check out, put video to our audio from the Edinburgh Now YouTube page. Live stream, search Edinburgh Now on YouTube and you'll be right there.
Pretty easy.
Ali back in there. He has the ball. 6-10 is the updated score. Pass over to Adams. Shot is up. This one rolls off. And rebound underneath.
I guess I should have been keeping track. I keep on forgetting we do not have the live stats for wheelchair basketball, but I'm curious of field goal percentage right now.
Reverse layup, no good, but Willie Brachuk, that was an impressive move to get there and have the ability for the layup.
Kevin Athley. He managed to get back up. 10-6 in favor of the Canadian under 23 team.
And Canada takes the timeout. We are going to take a timeout with them this time. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Don't go anywhere.
10-6 in favor of the Canadian under 23 team.
And Canada takes the timeout. We are going to take a timeout with them this time. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Don't go anywhere.
10-6 in favor of the Canadian under 23 team.
And Canada takes the timeout. We are going to take a timeout with them this time. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
Is your source of running going anywhere?
10-6 in favor of the Canadian under 23 team.
And Canada takes the timeout. We are going to take a timeout with them this time. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Canada takes the timeout. We are going to take a timeout. We are going to take a
halves, not the quarter system. So we have two long 20-minute halves instead of the short four quarters that they do in women's college basketball. So I don't know if I like it that way, but that's the way that they do it, especially in wheelchair basketball.
Canada gets it stolen away by Ali. Pass ahead to Adams, trying to shoot his way through. Shot is up, no good. And the foul. That's a good foul by Willie underneath. Willie's rocking the headband and the ponytail.
I like it. Anytime you can rock a ponytail, I encourage it.
As someone who can rock a ponytail. Yeah. I don't have the hair for that.
Yeah, you do.
Are you kidding me?
Maybe when we go off air, I'll tell you why.
Mike Adams' first shot, no good. Second one coming up. This one, no good, and Mike Adams is cold.
Yeah, I really don't understand what's going on. It's not like this Edinburgh team to be missing shots, especially free throws.
At the top, pass around. We're going to swing it back out to the top. Willie Maronic. In, this one is a three up off the mark. And bouncing ahead, Appley went back expecting a turnover. Shot is up and good, and the foul underneath on Wolf.
I mean, it looks like Canadian under 23 team is heating up at the moment. They're playing good basketball, getting rebounds, making their shots and drawing fouls. So we'll see if Edinburgh can stick with them in this game while missing their shots. You have Mike Adams, who, as you mentioned before, is an All-American who just missed two free throws in a row. That's definitely not like him.
And shot is good. There. Edinburgh trying to respond as the under 23 Canada team has doubled up. 13-6 pass to Ali. Skip pass to Adams to the top for speed. Speed from the foul line. Shot is up. This one off. No good. Rebound by Canada.
So we are halfway through the first half already. Kind of a quick game so far. I think that has a lot to do with
it. There's not a lot of stoppages. And when they are, they're quick to get up from the chair. Shot is up, no good. Fighting for it underneath, went off of the wheel of Will Speed. It will stay with Canada. Wheelchair basketball action all weekend for you. As today there's two Edinburgh matches, and tomorrow we'll have three. Be right here on 88.9 WFSC and Edinburgh Television. Shot is up. This one, no good. Mike Adams got a hand on it. He has the ball. Adams pass out to Affley. passing it into the corner. Skip pass to Chase Wolf. Wolf has a shot. It's up. This one is no good, just short. And tipped out of play. It will stay with the Fighting Scots.
We'll see if Speed can get anything. I think he's going to try to work to Adams right here on an open shot, an open three. Take it, try to get hot.
And Mike Adams will take that three right in and out. Athlete trying to clean up. And he makes a second opportunity.
What did I say, Drew? I knew it was going to happen. I didn't predict the end with Atherly, but I predicted the beginning with Mike Adams. Yeah.
13-8, Canada still leads. Now, this is the Canadian under-23 team. We played Canadian Academy at the Borough Shootout.
I remember.
Shot is up. No good. Chase Wolf trying to get the rebound, but it goes into Mike Adams' hand. Hey, take that. Is knocked away.
Stolen by Willie Moranchuk.
Trying to save it, pass in, and Moranchuk hits the ground pretty hard. And this ball just floating. And that's good for Edinburgh because that floated all the way back across the court and almost to the very corner of the court. And it's Edinburgh's ball. So they have it on their own side. Will Speed into Adams. Pass out to Speed. Now that's his go-to shot from the line over to Atherley. Atherley's shot is up, and Kevin Atherley has been the man so far for the Fighting Scots.
You mentioned that Speed shot. He's missed a couple from there so far, so maybe I think he's hesitant to take that shot this game.
And Edinburgh trying to go on a run of their own to tighten this gap. Looking for the pass, but actually able to just put his mitt up and steal that one away. Pass to Ali, floating in layup is good for Ayuba Ali underneath the basket. He's one of those guys who likes to do the glide in there. He's
Canadian under 23 team going to take a timeout. I mean, just less than a minute ago, it was 13-6, but now we have a 13-12 game.
And we're going to take a 30-second break. Don't go anywhere. With 8 minutes left to go in the first half, 13-12 to score with Canada in the lead. This is Edinburgh Wheelchair Basketball on the Edinburgh Sports Network.
Gabe Hypes, this is not Drew Patrick, because here's Drew now.
Yes. Welcome back to the action to Macomb Fieldhouse. And Canada, after the timeout, they'll come back in. The Fighting Scots on defense. Trying to set up, pass over to the wing. Trying to drive into the corner, back to the top. A pass down low to Moranchuk. Shot is up and good, and he'll go to the line.
A good timeout for Canadian under 23 team now, managing to get a 3-point play opportunity. And this is something that you don't see in basketball if you're watching a live stream. It's really only in wheelchair basketball. You have play going 24/7. You have guys trying to block out. He makes the first free throw and the only free throw, but guys trying to box out 24/7. You watch free throws in just basketball, and it's kind of they just stand around and kind of just wait till the action picks up. Wheelchair basketball is nonstop. It has to be tiring.
Yeah, and it's mostly about positioning. I mean, that's the name of the game. If you can get good positioning, you'll be set. Pass over to Wolf. Wolf wanted to shoot, decides against it to Adams. He'll drive closer, goes back to Wolf. Wolf shot up, this one off, no good.
I'm not sure how these players are not getting confused by these whistles. It's confused me every single second. It's a whistle from the other side, and I'm thinking that Elias play stopped.
Canada trying to respond, pass over to the wing. It's Voronchek spinning around, good move. Pass down low, shot is up, and good. Underneath. And it's 18-12 with Canada on top of the Fighting Scots right now. Ali just got a coast in the middle. Shot is up off the glass. And there you could have got closer. I think he rushed that shot just a bit. He was coming in right directly towards it, so you could probably get the layup that you wanted, but a little rushed. Underneath, and a timeout from Coach Glatch this time. So with 6:37 left to go in the first half, we're going to take another 30-second break. Don't go anywhere. This is Wheelchair Basketball on the Edinburgh Sports Network. House Wheelchair Basketball for you. This is the first game that we'll have for you today. The second one a little later, Edinburgh against the Canadian under 23 national team in this matchup, and they'll face Wisconsin Whitewater at 1:15 later today.
Wisconsin Whitewater is good at pretty much every sport. Football, they're one of the main teams that win the national championship for Division III, along with Mount Union every year. I believe there were national champions in wheelchair basketball recently also.
Last year they were the national champions.
Good sports school.
Vincent DeLassi for Canada. Where is it now? Pass over. Going back, but Atherley. I mean, he's still very tall. He's probably the tallest player on the court right now. Height, even in the chair. Adams trying to set up, shot is up, and there it goes. Mike Adams, 14-18. No score. Trying to respond quickly. There's a lane. Right, decides against that pass back over. Shot up, this one off, no good. And speed and to get the rebound. Atherley trying to coast quickly, almost lost the ball. Over the back pass over to Adams. Adams trying to get set for a shot. The shot up, off, no good. So yeah, very cold day for Mike Adams. Willie Maranchuk pass over at DeLassi, shot up, no good, and Atherley able to get the rebound. Pass ahead, but this one taken away. Oh, but not too long. Atherley able to recover. And we have a stoppage as Wolf hit the deck.
A lot of fouls and falling in this game so far. Kind of a very competitive, very physical game so far.
The Fighting Scots trail by 4, trying to respond over to Wolf. Wolf shot up, and that one is in for Chase Wolf. And we have a 2-point game.
16-18.
driving in Delossi. Pass. Shot is up. No good. Rebound underneath. Mrazek. Second chance. No good, but Atherley can't get the rebound, and it goes out.
Kind of Atherley tipped it to the other team.
They were in good position to get the rebound. They had the better positioning. Shot up. No good. Atherley this time won't let it go out of his hands.
I think there was four Edinburgh players in great positioning to get that rebound, but it just went exactly where you didn't want it to go.
Adams, far side. Pass to Speed. Back to Adams. Pass down to Atherley. Off the glass, no good. A little too hard off the glass. And that was your tying shot there, just a little too strong.
Still a lot of game left, though.
Good play there, just a shot too hard. And a great pass from Willie Mrazek to Vincent Delossi. And that ball off the wheel and out of play. It's back to Canada. Pass over. Ball lost. Atherley is rocking it on the defensive side right now. Mike Adams to the corner. He'll go back to the far side wing and he'll pass it back out. They'll reset. Under 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Pass down to Wolf. Wolf has a shot. It's up and it's good, and we are tied at 18 apiece. Vincent Delossi trying to respond for Canada. Stops at the foul line. Shot is up and a great shot. And remember, these are the best select few at Canada has to offer on the under 23 team. The national tournament is in June, and Chase Wolf will be on the United States team. Pass back. Good passing around. McNally has it on the far side. He'll swing it over. Back to Wolf. Down to Atherley. Good pass. And we are tied once again at 20.
Edinburgh is doing a really good job of just staying in this game, getting points when you want to. You don't want to get that too big a separation like there was in the beginning of this half. Edinburgh is doing a really good job of getting nice, easy shots with Atherley.
Shot missed by Mrazek underneath. And we have a stoppage there as the buzzer in the other game goes off.
I was confused too. It's rough.
There's a minute 37 left in the first half for here, but the first half on the other game is over. Now, if you guys are unfamiliar with Macomb Fieldhouse, or if you're not seeing it from our ETV camera, there's two courts in here. There's one on the far side and then the main court. Edinburgh's here on the main court. McNally, pass over to Adams. The score is tied. Chance for Edinburgh to take the lead over to Wolf. Shot is up. Chase Wolf puts Edinburgh in the lead, 22-20. Driving Vincent Delossi will pass back to the top. We'll pass it over. It's Mrazek. They'll shoot the three. This one up and good from downtown for Willie, who's been the star for that team. Under a minute now to go. Will Speed hits the deck. He's unhappy with it. He was banging his hand on the ground. Because when you fall like that, when you fall head first, they usually stop.
Mm-hmm. It's
especially when you're in the middle.
Yes. it's hard to get back up. It really is. Usually, it doesn't matter what team you are on. You help out with either side trying to get back up.
Shot for three the other way, and there's your All-American Mike Adams for three, 25-23 Edinburgh lead.
First lead of the game. No shot clock now. Canadians can hold it for the final shot.
And they're trying to pick Appley back at midcourt. Because he's been the disruptor down low. Shot over, this one for three, the other side, and that's in. And that gives the lead right at the end of the half to Canada. That's a big shot there at the end by Willie Maranchuk. And boy, was that a fun first half. 26-25 is your score at the half. We're going to take a two-minute break. We'll be right back. This is Wheelchair Basketball on the Edinburgh Sports Network. Against the Canadian under 23 national team, it is 26-25 after a three-pointer by Willie Maranchuk at the end of the half there. I'm Drew Patrick alongside Gabe Hypes, and we're gonna have a pretty exciting second half coming up here.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, 25-26, it was Edinburgh with the lead until that dagger of a three-pointer by, I believe it was Willie Maranchuk, right at the end, kind of near the buzzer, I think, with like just about 1 second to go. So gave them the 26-25 lead. It could really go either way. Both teams started off super, super slow, missing a lot of the shots, missing a lot of layups, missing a lot of free throws. But both teams seem to have turned it around. And I wouldn't be surprised if both teams easily break the 50 point mark, maybe even a 60 point mark.
Yeah, I think the shots started to come better for both teams towards the end of that half. Although now you got to switch and shoot on the other hoop. But the shots started going, the players were getting more comfortable, and I think that is going to be the difference, or a difference, in this, yeah, this second half.
We'll see if Mike Adams, we saw a couple of times, he missed. He was missing at the beginning, but then he started to get decent shots, decent opening, but he was giving a lot of assists also. So Mike Adams is a huge player and athlete right now. He's playing really good. He has most of Edinburgh's points, mostly down low, and he's playing really good defense also.
Yeah, Kevin Atherley has been great in that first half there. He was a force down low, offensively and defensively. When you can have a man who's got such a bigger upper body that, you know, you could be a force down low, and towards the end, before that final shot, they're going to try to pick him a lot. They're going to try to pick Kevin Atherley because they don't want him to disrupt down low. They don't want it to happen.
I think you're right, Drew. That's one of the things that makes wheelchair basketball unique. It's basically like if you're comparing it to, like, let's say, just basketball, it would be like somebody grabbing another player and just holding on and keeping them in the backcourt so they can't be used, which just seems insane. But in wheelchair basketball, using your chair to block somebody else's wheelchair so they can't get into the game, it's just good strategy. It really is. And so that's what they're doing. They want to keep Atherley out of the game. So even if it's free throws, even if it's a break in the action where they're throwing the ball in, they're going to be on Atherley and jamming their chair into his chair to cause disruption and to cause them to not get back and to cause them to not play good defense or offense.
Yeah, with a team like this, Edinburgh, I feel, is a team that has scorers throughout.
Mm-hmm.
You have, obviously, you have your All-American, Mike Adams. Ayuba Ali, who's coming off an injury, and Will Speed, both of them coming off injuries, but they're usually very good scorers for this squad. And also, off the bench, Alex Soleil, he's a good force down low when you put him down low as well. And you got other guys on this team who know how to score. Seamus McNally has a good shot. We haven't seen a lot of him in that first half, but these are guys on this team that all can shoot. It just hasn't gone in.
Yeah, I think that's the thing right now. The shots didn't go in. In the beginning of the first half, at least, the shots, it seemed like you mentioned, there was something on the rim. There was something blocking the rim. It was every shot being missed, even the easy ones, the layups, the easy for an athlete down there. You mentioned how tall he was even sitting down, and he still wasn't able to get those layups to hit. That might just be a testament to the Canadian under 23 team, because they're playing good defense also, but I do believe that maybe it was just a 9:45 game, and I mean, that's early. It's the first game of the day for both teams. I think maybe they just needed some time, and I think they're showing that, and I think we're going to have much more scoring in the second half.
And also, it's going to be a jam-packed day of wheelchair basketball, but it's going to be a jam-packed day of athletics, as tonight at 7 p.m. will be Edinburgh Wrestling at its finest as they welcome the number one team in America into Macomb Fieldhouse. That's Oklahoma State. That match begins at 7 o'clock, and Gabe, you'll be on the call with for that one.
I'm worried about it, but I'm excited about it. I'm not worried about calling it.
We're going to have you guys talk it out before we...
I'm not worried about calling it with Tubby. I'm fine with that. I'm worried about the match. It's
going to be interesting. There's some good ranked matchups we have here for Edinburgh on that one. We're going to take another about 60-second break. And when we come back, we'll have the start of the second half for you. Don't go anywhere. This is Edinburgh Wheelchair Basketball on the Edinburgh Sports Network. Am I getting sick?
He might be in sick.
I've been sick and tried to call games, and then I had laryngitis for a week. I don't want it to happen again. That's the greatest thing I've ever seen. Bam, bam. Welcome back here to Macomb Fieldhouse wheelchair basketball action for you as Edinburgh is taking on the Canadian under 23 national team. And it's a jam-packed day of wheelchair basketball in Macomb Fieldhouse. Today, the last match today will be at 1.